Welcome back. Well, folks, just imagine no cell phone.
No computer, no TV.
No texting.
We challenged one Triad family addicted to technology to give it all up for 2 whole days.
And as Kim Gebbia reports tonight, their reaction is nothing to LOL about.
It started with a cell phone, the gateway drug to the laptop.
My husband says that that thing's practically attached to my lap.
It's a slippery slope.
Then came the e-reader.
To a new kind of addiction.
Then they came out with the DSs, and my daughter and I had to play with each other with those.
An addiction to technology.
Oh, and the iPod, I have that too.
Tammy Ward and her 13-year-old daughter Kylie are known to sit on their laptops while watching TV, while texting.
Probably mostly TV and my computer. Is what I'm most addicted to.
My husband and I have been known to chat with each other on Facebook, too, back and forth from one chair to the other.
And Kylie will text her mom.
Mom, I'm hungry. What's for breakfast?
From her bedroom just feet away.
Bagels and cereal. Depends on what you want.
All the while, they know this technology is cutting into time they could be spending actually, you know, talking to each other.
I've been saying for a while, my husband, too, let's do that family game night. Let's just turn off the TV and do it. But we're not doing it because we have all this other stuff in front of us.
Some people, I think, feel trapped. They feel stuck. They feel unable to break away from technology.
Family therapist Malcolm Rubenstein says the Ward's habits are unfortunately normal.
So you'll often see if you go out to eat in a restaurant, a family of 4 people who are sitting at the same table, but they're not talking because they're checking their emails, they're texting their friends, they're listening to an iPod. And it really interferes with what should be close family relationships.
Now it's about breaking those habits. We asked the Wards to unplug everything and go cold turkey on technology. Yes, we're even asking the Ward family to turn off Channel 12 for 48 hours and give up all the rest of their technical devices. The question is, will this self-admitted tech-addicted family shut down without them? Day one, that family game night finally happens, but Dad's about to buckle.
I'm going to watch TV.
He resists, they survive. Day two, the girls go bowling, something Kylie told us she's wanted to do for a while. And at home, Mom's dropped her e-reader for some actual paper.
I guess I'll do some puzzles.
But by the end of day two, the Wards slowly crumble. One by one, they fall like their game of dominoes.
No electronics. What do I do? I sit in bed, completely, 100% bored.
Daybreak, we come to the rescue.
How did it go?
We're ready to get online, I can tell you that.
For Kylie, in one word, this experience was...
Horrible.
We're ready to turn on the TV, open up the computers. I'm sure she's just itching to text her friends.
And although they are back with phones in hand and laptops open, they've also opened their minds to shutting down their addiction, just not for 2 days straight.
I do think it's good for you to shut it all off once in a while.
Well, Dr. Rubenstein says families should make a certain amount of time to put all gadgets away every night, either during dinner or 30 minutes after dinner.
He says too much technology can have long-term effects on the young people who might not be able to communicate effectively when they become adults.
We asked visitors to WXII 12's Facebook page, are you a techno addict? Darlene Tate told us, yeah, I'm proud of it, LOL. I won't go 48 hours without some form of technology.
Ann Freeman, even worse off, she says, I can't go 24 hours without technology, let alone 48.
But not everybody is so technology dependent. Ronald Cates adds, it's actually easier to do than it sounds, although it's hard for me to go a long time with no internet connection.